Hi friends, so here we have to find out the value of p if f of z is given as r square cos 2 theta plus I r square sin p theta, and if this f of z is analytic. So now guys, whenever a given function is analytic, we know that it satisfies the Cauchy Riemann equation. So since this function is given as analytic, it should satisfy the Cauchy Riemann equation. So let's find out the Cauchy Riemann equation, and from those Cauchy Riemann equation we will find out the value of p. Now to prove the Cauchy Riemann equations, we have two types of Cauchy Riemann equation. One is in polar coordinates and one is in Cartesian coordinates. But since f of z is given in polar coordinate term, that is in terms of r and theta, we will use the Cauchy Riemann equation in polar coordinates. So here I'll say, since f of z is analytic, it must satisfy CR equations or Cauchy Riemann equations. So therefore the CR equations are dou u by dou r is equal to 1 upon r dou v by dou theta, and dou v by dou r is equal to minus 1 upon r dou u by dou theta. So I'll give this as equation number 1. Now to find out these values, we need to find out u and v first. So for that, let's start from the function. So we know that f of z is equal to u plus iv. It means the real part is u and the imaginary part is v. So therefore here we'll say u is equal to r square cos of 2 theta and v is equal to r square sin of p theta. Now let's find out the values. So let's differentiate u with respect to r. So since we are differentiating partially, so theta is constant, so cos 2 theta is constant, and the derivative of r square is 2r. Similarly, dou u by dou theta would be r square constant as it is, and the derivative of cos 2 theta is minus sine of 2 theta into the derivative of 2 theta, that is 2. Next, the partial differentiation of v with respect to r is 2r sin p theta constant, so I will write it as it is, and dou v by dou theta would be r square as it is. The derivative of sin p theta is cos p theta into p. So we got all the four terms of Cauchy Riemann equations. Now let's substitute these four terms in the equation number 1. So therefore we will get dou u by dou r, that is 2r cos 2 theta, 1 by r dou v by dou theta, that is this value. So 2r cos of 2 theta equal to 1 by r into r square cos of p theta into p. So I have substituted these two values in this equation. Now guys, let's solve this, because here only we'll get the value of p. So by cancelling this r and r, we'll get r cos p theta into p, or rp cos p theta. So here I'll write, therefore 2r cos of 2 theta is equal to pr cos of p theta. Now I can cancel r and r from both sides. So 2 cos 2 theta is equal to p cos p theta. And if these two terms are same, then p has to be is equal to 2. So I can say that p is equal to 2. So therefore we got the value of p when f of z is given as analytic function. Thank you.